Before donning the EVA PAPR, the user should thoroughly review all the appropriate product information, including system components, key specifications, the user manual, paying particularly close attention to the cautions, limitations, and warnings, and the pre-operational checklist. A NIOSH-approved EVA Powered Air Purifying Respirator system consists of four components: the hood or mask, the breathing tube, the blower assembly, including belt and battery, and the purifying filter cartridge. Each of these four components must be present to maintain NIOSH approval. Consult the NIOSH approval label located in the user instruction manual for a complete list of approved components. Before donning the EVA PAPR, the user should carefully read and understand the manual provided with the product. The manual has valuable information concerning warnings, cautions and limitations, principles of operation, battery pack, pre-operational checklist, mounting the breathing tube, checking airflow, air purifying elements, mounting and replacing cartridges, donning the blower, low battery alarm, troubleshooting, NIOSH approval label, ordering information, and cleaning and storage. Users of the EVA PAPR product should note the following: the EVA series respirator does not supply oxygen. The unit should be used only in adequately ventilated areas containing at least 19.5% oxygen. The unit should not be used when concentrations of contaminants are immediately dangerous to life or health, IDLH, as defined in 20 CFR 1910.134B. Do not use these respirators for respiratory protection during abrasive blasting or cleanup. Do not use in circumstances where the airborne concentration level of contaminant exceeds the maximum use concentration for this type of respirator, as established by regulatory standards. Leave the area immediately if breathing becomes difficult, dizziness or distress occurs, you taste or smell the contaminant, the unit becomes damaged, the battery alarm activates, or the low flow alarm activates. This apparatus must not be worn with the blower unit switched off, as it may cause a rapid buildup of carbon dioxide and depletion of oxygen, which could result in death or serious injury. Never alter or modify this respirator. Use only Bullard NIOSH approved EVA series components and replacements and replacement parts for this respirator. This device is not immune to high-powered RFI or EMI emissions. Failure to follow these warnings could result in death or serious injury. In addition, users should be aware of the following cautions. This unit is not for use in atmospheres containing less than 19.5% oxygen. This unit is not for use in atmospheres immediately dangerous to life or health. Do not exceed maximum use concentrations established by regulatory standards. Do not use respirator if airflow is less than 4 CFM or 115 LPM for tight-fitting face pieces or 6 CFM, 170 LPM for hoods and or helmets. Follow the established cartridge and canister change schedules or observe ESLI to ensure that cartridges are replaced before breakthrough. This unit does contain electrical parts that may cause an ignition in flammable or explosive atmospheres. Failure to properly use and maintain this product could result in injury or death. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration regulations require gas-proof goggles to be worn with this respirator when used against formaldehyde. Follow the manufacturer's user instructions for changing cartridges and/or filters. All approved respirators shall be selected, fitted, used, and maintained in accordance with MSHA, OSHA, and other applicable regulations. Never substitute, modify, add, or omit parts. Use only exact Bullard replacement parts in the configuration as specified by the manufacturer. Please refer to the user's instructions and/or maintenance manuals for information on use on the maintenance of these respirators. NIOSH does not evaluate respirators for use as surgical masks. Utilize the EVA pre-operational checklist included with each EVA PAPR blower assembly, and execute this checklist before donning. This checklist will guide you through physical inspections of the blower, battery, belt, filter, cartridge, hood, and breathing tube and operational checks of airflow and low flow alarm. Utilize the EVA pre-operational checklist. Execute the checklist before donning. Physical inspection of blower, battery, belt, filter cartridge, hood, and breathing tube. Perform operational checks of airflow and low flow alarm. To charge the EVA battery, select a safe location. Do not charge batteries in hazardous areas. First, plug the barrel connector of the charger power supply into the charger base. Then, plug the pronged connector of the charger power supply into the electrical outlet. Finally, insert the battery upside down into the charger base. The power supply LED will illuminate red while charging, and green when charging is complete. The EVA charger can charge an empty battery in approximately 4 hours. You should always inspect the battery pack for physical damage. Place the battery pack into the blower by inserting it into the battery compartment until the locking tab is engaged and clicks. Note, the battery has a built-in short circuit protection. In the event of a short circuit, an internal polyfuse will trip. The fuse will reset itself within 5 to 10 seconds, allowing the battery to resume normal operation. To install an EVA filter cartridge, follow these steps. If new, remove it from the packaging and record the in-service date on the label. Then inspect the filter cartridge and its sealing gasket. If used previously, check the age versus change schedule. With the locking tab of the filter cartridge oriented as if toward the 11 o'clock position on a clock, lower the filter cartridge into the blower port opening. Turn the filter cartridge clockwise until the locking tab completely engages at the 12 o'clock position. To determine your cartridge life by measuring environmental and usage factors, customers can download Bullard's Max Life Calculator. Inspect the breathing tube for physical damage. You should always verify that a rubber gasket is in place in the breathing tube port of the blower unit. Screw the threaded end of the breathing tube into the blower unit, and hand tightening is sufficient. To test the airflow, with the gasket present in the breathing airway port, attach the breathing tube to the blower unit. With the filter cartridge installed, turn the blower power on. Hold the free end of the breathing tube upright and place the airflow indicator into the end without blocking the outlet holes. Apply a slight downward pressure on the airflow indicator against the breathing tube to get a reasonable seal. If the ball is completely above the pass line, then the system is ready for use. To test the low flow alarm, press the on-off button of the blower and hold down for 1 to 2 seconds to turn the unit on. Then, cover the breathing tube port with your hand and wait approximately 5 seconds. The 77 decibel audible alarm will sound, indicating a low flow condition of less than 185 LPM. Before donning a hood or loose-fitting face pieces, do the following. Inspect the hood for rips, tears, or damage from excessive wear. Inspect the inner neck cuff, if applicable, for elasticity. Inspect the lens for cracks, scratches, or any other signs of damage. And, if applicable, inspect the headband for tears, cracks, or fraying straps.